I'm Highlighter Vision Experts.com. Welcome to this beginner's guide of Vision 10. In this video, I'm going to present a method to start off with a bead, just because I thought it would be fun. Because creating a bead could be done using two different ways. Like I've said before, it's either the redrum or it's going to be a comb kit. It kind of depends like what you're used to using. Personally, there is different applicable usage versus Kong versus the redrum. Because, well, the redrum has a step sequencer, and from an electronic type of gear method, I prefer to use the redrum because of its look and feel. So I'll start off with that and maybe do one with Kong later. So the first thing that I will do is take a, let's go for a drum kit. I'll go for a tight kit. Let's just locate it over there. Stick that in there. Just drag and drop it. Another alternative route would be just going like this. You take factory sound banks and then you go for redrum drum kits and then you go for a tight kit. This could also work. And then drag the tight kit on the sequence itself. That's all working, right? But in this case, I'm going to use the step sequencer. And this is also one reason why I'm going to go for the rack first. So I can use the pattern step sequencer to make my drum work. The only thing that I need to do is press run and say I'm going to place a bass drum over here and over there. I'm going to place a snare drum over there. I'm going to play some hi-hats over here. Too hard, too soft. And to make it easier for myself, I'm just going to play the hard notes first, right there. And then the soft notes in between, right there, right there. Then I can use the velocity switch over here to make changes within like how hard the hard notes are going to be and how soft the soft notes are going to be. Adjust the level just a little bit. I will go for an open hi-hat over there. I'm also going to slap in a rim shot in between there. I'm going to go for there. That's a decent starting point. While using the step sequencer, if I press run, I get this going on. It starts to flange because that has everything to do with the fact that this thing is still enabled. So I can disable that right there. Going back to the sequencer, press F7 and there's my sequence right here. So I can start making adjustments within, let's say, the end of this track over here, because otherwise it sounds like constantly playing the same thing over and over again. So what I will do is delete those notes over here, selecting the notes and then pressing delete. And over here I will go for a tom-tom setup like this. Just like that. Nothing special there. So that's my starting point. Next thing that I'll bring in is a instrument that's going to be an instance of NNXT. And one thing that I'm going to do in particular is go for the factory sound bank instead. I will go for an upright bass. That's located inside of the bass section. Another piece of advice that I can give over here is familiarize yourself with the setup of the factory sound bank in particular. Like how it's set up. For instance, if you take any instrument that's out there, because this is all instrument based, you have NNXTs. Which is the sample library. Then you have different type of categories, like you have basses, you have rhythmic sections, synth effects, synth leads, and stuff like those. And this is kind of like categorized throughout all those different instruments. For instance, the Melsum also has this bass, FX, mono, synth, stuff like that. But other than that, there is also a section that's called the Reason 10 Sounds, and these are all based on different categories. So in this case, it doesn't really matter what type of synth I'm actually going to use, because all those sounds are already there, and it basically tells, like, in the extension, what type of instrument it is. I know from the fact that SXT stands for the NNXT. So I'll play a riff. I will just slow down the tempo over here. Let's go for 90 beats per minute. Now, the benefit behind this whole thing is that I'm sloppy on the keys, But I can fix that by double clicking on this layer over here. Double click on this layer over here. Press Ctrl A, press Ctrl K, and thus that will quantize all the notes. Get rid of pre-quick right there. Okay, that sounds fine with me. Next thing that I can take over here is let's go for the region 10 sounds. And I will need something like a pad up thing, like a string session or something. Do I have something like strings? I think I have strings. Let's see. Edge of the Earth. Sounds nice. Let's go for that. Press record. I'm going to go for pre-click enabled, because in this case it allows me to press record, it clicks four times, and then it starts to record the whole thing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, that's sloppy. I will get rid of this. Duplicate the session. Paste the session. Ctrl C, Ctrl V. I will also quantize these notes, so I'm going to select all these sounds over here, right click, join these clips, double click it, press Ctrl A, press Ctrl K, there, then these notes are actually quantized. But I also noticed over here that some notes are a little bit off. I'm just going to fix that real quick. That thing can move though also. Why is this here? I have no idea. Let's get rid of that. Okay, fine. There's that. Let's go for some... I will go for a clang. Because it has this circular bell type of thing. But in this case, I want to apply a reverb. And in this case, I'm not going to use the stock native reverb that sits inside of this device itself. One thing that I'm going to do is do the creative process of it all. I will say show insert effect. I'm going to apply an effect over here that's going to be an additional reverb. It's going to be the RV7000. Because I have a feeling that in most cases I have a feeling like I want to have a specific artifact that I can stretch it longer, and that's going to be handled through the remote program over here inside of the RV7000. In this case I will go for a type that is called Arena, and then I can stretch it pretty long by using a really long decay time, sounds like that, and then I will balance it out by using the dry wet balance knob over there. Nice. Next thing that I will do is let's go for pre-click and record the sequence. There. I'm really sloppy on the keys over here. The thing that I want to avoid over here is because by default it is set to 1/16th note. So in this case I want to have the whole quantizer session to be 1/32 notes instead, because I'm using these really short transitions. So I will press Ctrl A, Ctrl K right there. And then I've got to fact check if everything is actually doing what I wanted to do. In this case it's actually wrong. So I'll set this thing to 1/32. I will move this up. I will move that up. That's a little bit like trial and error stuff that's happening over there. Then I can move this up. I can move that up. Let's go for that route. I think that should be working. I'm not sure, but there goes that. Timing is way off over here. Let's see here. Let's fix this. Let's fix that. Okay. That's the beauty if you're using a sequencer, because you can always remove your mistakes. I'll smooth that up as well. Okay. That's my intro. Let's smooth this up. Duplicate this whole session. Then I will go from this to that. And keep that playing. But in this case, I'm just going to go for a piano. Let's go for a piano, scales and chords. Piano right there. Skills and chords player, let's bring that in there as well, right there. I'll go for minor chords, set to C sharp. No, I'm going to go for major chords. Right there. Okay. That's fine, let's see if I can record this. Now I'm lost. okay, let's slice this up. Let's get rid of this. Press Ctrl A, and I'm going to quantize this on, again, 1/16 notes, right there. Press Ctrl A, press Ctrl K. There's that. The only thing that I kind of missed is the last part. So what I will do is slice this part up, duplicate it, I'll go for this direction instead, there. Now it's just a matter of copy and pasting. Copy paste, let's go for this direction. Select all these notes over here, copy paste right here. And then say copy paste right here. But then I'm going to probably double stem it. Let's go for this, copy paste. Select all this section over here. I need just this section over here. Copy and then paste. I will press Ctrl D, select all these notes over here. And then press delete. And then we'll do this, loop it over here, and then I can double stem it. The trick that I often go for, especially if I'm going to use something like scales and chords, is that eventually when I press a chord over here, or a note over here, it's just one note that I'm tricking, just show you over here. When I press one key, it plays a whole complete chord. But the benefit, if I'm going to set this thing to note one, and I press a key, it just plays one note. So in this case, everything that I'm doing inside of this whole keyboard lane right now, it will also automatically translate towards the chord that I'm triggering, because it all translates towards major C sharp. So with that in mind, I don't have to worry about making a mistake, because now I can just basically hammer on the keyboard and everything will be fine. That's the cool part with this whole setup. So I'll go one octave higher. I'm really sloppy on the keys right there, but it doesn't really matter because we can fix that. That was actually the intention of this whole thing. And also my microphone is in the way. But it doesn't really matter. We can fix things. Right here, let's go for this. Loop this. Let's pull that up. Move that up. I'll move this over here. And that's the beauty behind, if you're going to use a sequencer, you can always fix your mistakes. And that's the thing that I'm doing next. So I will get rid of this one. Get rid of this one right there. I can move that up over there. This is also wrong, by the way. I will also move this up over here, over there, over there, there. This is also pretty weird, by the way. I feel like such a newbie right now. But then again, welcome to beginner's class, right? This is kind of like the way that I started. Two notes are also pretty off. Also fix that. There. So the next thing that I will take is a... Let's press F8. Next thing that I'll take is a send effect. That's going to be a combination of an echo. And I will also apply a reverb as a send effect. In this case, I'm not going to go for that long. Just a little bit longer as the default state. We'll go for a setting around 93-ish. But because this is a send effect, I'm going to keep that thing on wet. It's the same thing with the delay. So going back to the mixer, that's F5. I have radical keys right there. I have radical piano right there. And that's my other tune. So I'm going to enable send effect 1 and 2, which is the delay and the reverb. Then it should now play with the delay right there. I have to fix that. Going to set the time on 1/4. This note is also off. I will also move that right there. So in this case, I can bring in my string section right here. But because I'm using an echo and a delay, I'm also going to, because I'm using an echo and a reverb, I'm going to make use of that while opening up that whole thing. Right here, right there. That's my string session. I'm going to get rid of the bell. Because I just want this thing to be there. That's just a string session. But in this case, I'm going to use that string session over there and enable these effects over there. But I'm going to use the default state with level on 0. And then I'm going to say right-click, edit automation. And then say right-click, edit automation right there. Because in this case, I can use the automation lane over here to make changes within the level, which is located over here. So I can draw on a point over here, draw on a point over there, and then I can start opening up that effect. That's the idea. So I'm going to drag this anchor point to the end, and I'm going to open it up over there and over there. So gradually, while that thing is progressing over time, I'm opening up the reverb and the delay while doing so. So this was like a little like a minor session, like to create a beat. Even while I said something like, I'm just going to create a beat to get started. Eventually, I'm actually making a complete song out of it. Have lots of fun, and I will talk to you later.